अब आगे देखें हम लोग बाइसेक्शन मेथड में वन मोर एग्जांपल सॉल्व एक्स क्यूब माइनस फोर एक्स माइनस नाइन इक्वल टू जीरो बाय बाइसेक्शन मेथड। लेट अस टेक ए इज इक्वल टू टू बी इज इक्वल टू थ्री देन एफ ए इज इक्वल टू एफ टू इज इक्वल टू टू क्यूब माइनस फोर इंटू टू माइनस नाइन सो इट इज माइनस नाइन लेस देन जीरो एंड एफ बी इज इक्वल टू एफ थ्री थ्री क्यूब माइनस फोर इंटू थ्री माइनस नाइन इज इक्वल टू ट्वेंटी सेवन माइनस ट्वेल्व माइनस नाइन एटी सिक्स ग्रेटर देन जीरो therefore f a into f b is equal to f 2 into f 3 which is less than 0 since minus 9 into minus 6 is minus 54 which is less than 0 so we can apply bisection method now x 0 will be a plus b by 2 a plus b means 2 plus 3 by 2 so it is 2.5 and f x 0 is 2.5 cube minus 4 into 2.5 minus 9 so it is minus 3.375 which is less than 0 greater than 0 less than 0 so the next root will lie in between 2.5 and 3 so x1 will be 2.5 plus 3 by 2 it is equal to 2.75 next evaluate fx1 is 2.75 cube minus 4 into 2.75 minus 9 it is plus 0.7968 which is greater than 0 therefore the next root lie will root lies in 2.5 to 2.75 because f 5 is less than 0 and f 2.75 is greater than 0. So the root will lie in between this interval. Now x2 will be 2.5 plus 2.75 by 2. It is equal to 2.625. And fx2 is your minus 1.4121, which is less than 0. Therefore, the next root x3 will lie in 2.625 and 2.75. Because at 2.75, it is fx2 is greater than 0, fx1 is greater than 0, and fx2 is minus 1.4121, which is less than 0. Next, x4 will be 2.625 plus 2.75 by 2. It is 2.6875. Therefore, fx4 will be negative. So, fx4 is less than 0. Therefore, x5 belongs to 2.6875 and 2.75. Now, we evaluate x5, which is 2.6875 plus 2.75 by 2. It is 2.71875. And now evaluate fx5, it is 0.2209, which is greater than 0. Therefore, x6 lies in 2.6875 to 2.71875. Now, let us see the next page. We will show this in a tabular form as given below. The first column is n, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Second column is for a, third column is for b. Next is for xn, another is for fxn. So n 0, 2, 3, 2.5, minus 3.375, 1, 2.5, 3, 2.75, 0.7968, and so on. So in this way, you just evaluate the values of x0, x1, x2, x3, x4, and so on. In some problems, it is given that evaluate the iteration up to x5 or x6 or x4. Do as given. If not given, evaluate at least up to x4. Next, the next topic is Newton's method or Newton-Raphson method. This method yields better results than that given by bisection method, regular falsi method, etc. We will study this method first and then some examples based on this method. See the formulation of this method. Formulation. Let fx is equal to 0 be the given equation. We have an equation given by fx equal to 0 with an initial approximation x0. x0 is an initial approximation. And also let x1 is equal to x0 plus h. Then fx1 is equal to 0 or fx0 plus h. It implies that fx0 plus h into fx f dash x0 plus h square by factorial to f double dash x0 plus 1 equal to 0. Above is an expansion of fx0 plus h by Taylor series. Suppose we neglect the second and higher order derivatives. Neglect this from this to last. Then one becomes fx0 plus h into f dash x0 is equal to 0. So h will be minus fx0 over f dash x0. Now x1 will be x0 plus h. It means x1 is equal to x0 minus substitute the value of h is fx0 by f dash x0. Similarly, we can get successive approximations x2, x3, x4, so on, xn plus 1, where xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus fxn over f dash xn. This is our formula for Newton-Raphson method. This is the Newton-Raphson formula. Now let us see one example. Find the root of the equation x cube minus 2x minus 5 is equal to 0 using Newton's method. Let us see its solution. Let fx is equal to x cube minus 2x minus 5 equal to 0. Suppose fx is this given equation. Now we will evaluate f dash x and use this formula xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus fxn over f dash xn for the successive approximations. Now f dash x will be 3x square minus 2. Using Newton's method, xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus fxn over f dash xn. Xn plus 1 will be equal to xn minus fxn, means xn cube minus 2xn minus 5 by 3xn square minus 2. So xn plus 1 is equal to 2xn cube plus 5 by 3xn square minus 2. This is equation 2. For x0 is equal to 2, fx0 is minus 1, f dash x0 is 10. Since f2 is equal to 2 cube minus 2 into 2 minus 5, which is minus 1 less than 0, and f3 is 27 minus 6 minus 5, which is equal to 16 greater than 0. So therefore x0 plus 1 will be x0 minus fx0 over f dash 0. It is equal to 2 minus minus 1 by 10, which is 2.1 for n is equal to 0. Next, fx1. Fx1 is 2.1 cube minus 2 into 2.1 minus 5. It is equal to 0.061 for n is equal to 1. For fx1, we will substitute the value of x by x1. X1 means 2.1 in the given equation. Next, f dash x1 will be 3 into 2.1 square minus 2. It is equal to 11.23. Now, x2 will be x1 plus 1. It is equal to x1 minus fx1 over f dash x1. After substituting the values of x1, fx1 and f dash x1, the value of x2 comes out to be 2.094568. We will use this formula, xn plus 1 is equal to 2 into xn cube plus 5 by 3xn square minus 2. Use the scientific calculator for the evaluation. Similarly, we can evaluate x3, x4, x5 and so on. See another example. Find the root of the equation x sin x plus cos x is equal to 0. See its solution. X0 is equal to pi. So say take x0 is equal to pi, then make a table. In first table, write n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. In the another table, write the values of xn 3.1416, 2.8233, 2.7986, 2.7984. In the third column, write fxn minus 1.0, minus 0.0662, minus 0.0006, 0.0. And in the last column, xn plus 1, 2.8233, 2.7986, 2.7984, 2.7984. We have one more example. Solve the equation x cube minus 4x minus 9 equal to 0 by Newton-Raphson method. Given fx equal to x cube minus 4x minus 9 equal to 0, evaluate f dash x, it is 3x square minus 4. Now Newton-Raphson method will give you xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus fn over f dash xn. It is equal to xn minus xn cube minus 4xn minus 9 by 3xn square minus 4. So xn plus 1 is equal to 2xn cube plus 9 by 3xn square minus 4. So now take x0 is equal to 2, evaluate fx0, fx0 is minus 9, then evaluate x1, x2, x3 and so on using the formula xn plus 1 is equal to this one, 2xn cube plus 9 by 3xn square minus 4. So you will have no difficulty in evaluating all of these. Next. solve x minus cos x equal to 0 by Newton-Raphson method. It is another example. Here fx is equal to x minus cos x, which is equal to 0. Take x0 is equal to 1. Then fx0 will be 1 minus cos 1. It is 0.4597. Use Newton-Raphson method. Then xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus fn over f dash xn. F dash x is 1 plus sin x. So xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus cos xn by 1 plus sin xn. So it is equal to xn sin xn plus cos xn divided by 1 plus sin xn. Therefore, x1 will be x0 sin x0 plus cos x0 by 1 plus sin x0. So its value will come out to be 0.75036 after substituting the value of x0 is equal to 1. Therefore, fx1 is 0.01882. This x0 is 1 is, 1 is in radians. So in cos x, cos 1 radian. Remember this. Next, x2 will be x1 sin x1 plus cos x1 by 1 plus sin x1. It is 0.73911. And fx2 is equal to 4.161 into 10 to the power minus 5. It is 0.00004161. We will take x2 is equal to 0.73911. Since at this value of x, we get fx2 is equal to 0.00004161, which is approximately equal to 0. We can say it is equal to 0 as the approximate value of the root. So we, our aim is to find the value of x such that fx is equal to 0 or fx is nearly equal to 0. Next, one more very good example. Establish the formula xi plus 1 is equal to 1 upon 2 xi plus capital N by xi, and hence compute the value of under root 2, correct to 6 decimal places. Several times this type of questions were asked. Suppose the given equation is x square is equal to n. Since we need to find the root under root value of some number under root, therefore suppose x square is equal to n, then fx will be given as x square minus n equal to 0. F dash x will be 2x. We know that Newton Raphson formula is xn plus 1 is equal to xn plus fxn over f dash xn. So it will be xn plus fxn means xn square minus n by 2xn. This is equal to xn square plus capital N by 2xn. It means it is 1 upon 2 xn plus n by xn, which is of the form this 1 upon 2 xi plus n by xi. So the formula is established. For n is equal to I, xi plus 1 will be 1 upon 2 xi plus n by xi. So this part is proved. Now evaluate under root 2. Take n is equal to 2, then fx is equal to x square minus 2, which is equal to 0. F dash x will be 2x. Therefore, xi plus 1 is equal to 1 upon 2 xi plus 2 by xi, because this n is 2. So it is written as 2. For x0 is equal to 1, fx0 is 1 square minus 2, it is minus 1. Therefore, xi plus 1 will be 1 upon 2 xi plus 2 by xi. It implies that x1 is 1 upon 2 x0 plus 2 by x0. It is equal to 1 upon 2, 1 plus 2 by 1. So it is 1.5. Now fx1 is 0.25. Now evaluate x2, 1 upon 2 x1 plus 2 by x1. So 1 upon 2 is 1.5 plus 2 by 1.5. It is 1.4167. Now fx2 is 1.4167 whole square minus 2. It comes out to be 0.007039. Now x3 is 1.4167. Plus 2 by 1.4167, it is 1.414215. Now evaluate f1.4142 is equal to 1.4142 whole square minus 2, it is minus 0.00038. Therefore, the approximate value of under root 2 correct to 6 decimal places is 1.41425. Because at 41425, because at this we get fx equal to approximately 0.0040. It means this is our correct value of under root 2 using numerical methods. So this now these are sufficient matters for Newton-Raphson method. You note down all of them, and if you have any query, ask me here.